Pete Rock and CL Smooth, Mecca and the Soul Brother. Never heard it. Now, the first time I heard Pete Rock and CL Smooth was on their single, The Creator, from their 1991 EP, All Sold Out. That song stuck out to me for two reasons. One, it sounded a lot like Chubb Rock's Treat 'Em Right, which came out in 1990. And two, in the video and in the song, Pete Rock is rhyming and CL Smooth is DJing. And Pete Rock's not the greatest MC. And if you think I'm wrong about that, go listen to the Heavy D Posse joint Don't Curse and you tell me who dropped the ball on that one. So when they first came out with their EP, I wasn't really interested in them. But I will say by the next year, I did own the single Straighten It Out, which had They Reminisce Over You on the B-side. But I never bought the album, so here we go. But before I talk about the album, let's talk about Pete Rock's production. It uses these hard drums and jazz loops
that someone like Large Professor or Q-Tip might use.
But it marries it with the layered samples that someone like the Bomb Squad might use. And it creates this amalgamation that's hectic, but never chaotic. There's so much going on, but it always sounds smooth. And if I'm being honest, the production is doing the heavy lifting on this album. Now, CL Smooth is not a whack rapper by any means. But CL Smooth is like the Tim Duncan of MCs. He's a phenomenal player. He'll get you where you need to be. He's an all-star. But he's very boring to watch. CL's vocal inflection almost never changes throughout the entire album, no matter what he's talking about. And he talks about a lot of different topics, his family, romance, the Nation of Islam, but nothing ever changes about his flow. And I think that if you were to hear each song individually, it sounds really great. But hearing the exact same flow for an hour and 17 minutes is a bit much. So I'm not gonna go through every song, I'm just gonna highlight some of the things that I found interesting. For Pete's Sake is one of the few songs where both of the MCs are rapping on the same song. More often than not, it's either a Pete Rock song or it's a CL Smooth song, and never the two shall meet. Lots of Lovin' is one of the songs where CL Smooth does change up his sound a little bit. He sounds a lot smoother. Unfortunately, it's probably my least favorite song on the album. Now, Straighten It Out is a song that I listen to a whole lot, as I said before. But there was one thing about this song that I could never understand, and maybe you can explain it to me. In the first verse, he's talking about bootleggers that don't pay him. And in the second verse, he's talking about not wanting to pay the people that he samples, which feels a little hypocritical. Also, for the most part, CL Smooth doesn't curse. But on this song, he says ass. Soul Brother No. 1 is a Pete Rock solo track which uses the same JB sample that Public Enemy used in Rebel Without a Pause, which proves that just like everybody else, he was listening to the Bomb Squad. Now let's talk about They Reminisce Over You. I feel like what makes this song so fantastic, aside from the Tom Scott sample, is that even though it's a song about people who aren't here anymore, it's not a somber song. As soon as you hear those horns, you get excited. The first time you hear the song, you probably don't even realize it's a memorial song. It just sounds like he's talking about the people of his past, the people he grew up with. I'm not sure when the song was written, but it was released 2 years after Trouble T. Roy had died, which probably gave them a little more distance from the event. Most songs like this are written right after someone dies, so the song is a little more immediate and less universal. The most obvious example being Heavy D's Peaceful Journey, a great song, but nowhere on the level of They Reminisce Over You. Speaking of Heavy D, I was so happy to hear his voice on The Basement. This is a posse joint with Graf Love, Robbo, and Daddy Baby Pa. If it ain't rough, it ain't right. There's seven different samples on the song, but there are two that really stuck out to me. One is Once in a Lifetime by the Talking Heads. The way he's able to filter out the bass line is so clean. The second one I originally thought was a Fred Wesley solo from Pass the Peas by the JBs. But I looked it up and it's actually Fred Wesley's solo from Blues and Pants by James Brown. Which is crazy to me because when most people sample this song, they sample like the first four bars of it. The most famous being Notorious B.I.G.'s Dreams or Big L's Put It On. But where Pete Rock samples is 6 minutes into a 9 minute song. The way he filters out just the horn and the way he's able to stack it with all the other samples that are going on, phenomenal. So finally we have Skins.
CL Smooth's flow
has always reminded me of Grand Poopa. So when I heard Grand Poopa on this song, it really made sense. And he delivers some of my favorite lines on the entire album. He says, I take precaution before I slide into the slit. Man, fuck that, I put aluminum foil on my dick. Better yet, you can pass me the Ziploc. He's taking no chances in 92. And this is undoubtedly my favorite line of the entire album. Hit the skins hard, she'll hang on to the bedpost. Then I drop my load, then get up and make some French toast. This is also the only other song where CL Smooth and Pete Rock are rapping on the same track. I absolutely understand why this album is a classic. It introduced the world to Pete Rock's superior production style, which has influenced countless producers after that. As far as MCing, I don't feel like anything new is being done here. I would take an instrumental version of this album any day. If I were to take this album and put it on shuffle with a bunch of other albums, I would probably like each individual song. But as far as listening to this album beginning to end, probably not. So have you heard Mecca and the Soul Brother? Are you still buffing it to this day? I'm gonna be doing reviews until I run out of albums. Don't know when that is. Please like and subscribe. See you next time.